So it's important for you to recognize that DNA never leaves the nucleus. It never comes in direct contact with the machinery necessary to build proteins called ribosomes. And as a solution to this problem, there's an intermediate step that involves a chemical cousin of DNA known as RNA. So although DNA never leaves the nucleus, a copy is made, and this copy is composed of a very closely related molecule called RNA. It's kind of like taking a big book of recipes, or our big genome book here, and we're just Xeroxing a few pages that we're interested in that'll help us make the protein we need. Obviously, we don't need the whole genome to make one protein, but there are sequences of information that are necessary to make up individual proteins, and we just want to make copies of what we need and bring them out to the cytoplasm to read. This copying process must happen for every protein-coding gene, any gene that's going to produce a protein, including the ABO gene. So for the ABO gene to be turned into protein, we'll first make a copy that'll be brought to the cytoplasm and then turned into protein. This basic process of making copies of DNA, bringing it to the cytoplasm to make protein, is so important to almost all life forms on our planet that we call it the central dogma. And the central dogma takes on a very specific form in these three words organized in a certain order. They're found up here. I just want to see if you can plug them into the boxes in the right order. Blank to blank to blank is the central dogma. See if you can figure out what belongs in each one.